Hello YouTube, talk about internet security issues, specifically domain names.
I've been in domain names for a number of years, and I've been hacked from my own fault, because of stuff that I did. That allowed people to get into my domain name and hijack them and take the website offline or redirect the traffic to another website or whatever. So I want to tell you that if you have a website, you have to make sure that your administrative contact on your Whois contact information has to be valid. Otherwise, somebody can steal your domain name. There's recently this case where minimize.com. The UK spelling, not the American spelling, it has an S instead of a C. American spelling would have a C. Anyway, the guy who owns minimize.com had, since 99, he has a regular label he runs, and so he, had the email address on the Whois information was a Hotmail address that he no longer used. So somebody went in, registered that Hotmail address, then logged into went to Network Solutions, get the username and password for that domain name, and was able to transfer that domain name out of Network Solutions to GoDaddy within a couple hours time. And they eventually it got returned to the rightful owner, but from my own experience, I know how much of a headache that can be to have your domain name transferred out of your account without authorization. Say you have a domain name, even if it's just has sentimental value, and somebody goes takes it away. What are you gonna do? Now imagine if you had a name that's worth in the thousands of dollars, or tens of thousands, or hundreds of thousands, or millions, and somebody took it away. So and this has happened before, that people have hijacked domain names just because of that. There was this one guy when I was a moderator on the TN forum who he was using a stolen credit card on a PayPal account. He was buying up thousands of dollars worth of domain names, and he made one stupid mistake. He gave one of the users that he was buying a website from access to his hosting account and told him the password. I call him the what scammer because that was his password, was what. And Eddie then went to this guy's email address on Hotmail and put that password what in there too. And then he told me about it, and we went in and we took his domain names back that he had stolen from all these DN forum users. And there were like 9-10 domain names that he had stolen, and we returned them to their rightful owners. Every one of them was bought with a stolen credit card. So there's different ways that these hijackers will try to do this. And well, I've done my share of kind of vigilante type work when people try to steal domain names and stuff. I help out the owners, try to recover their property. It's not always easy, not always so successful, but if I can help somebody recover their rightful property, then that's great. Like, when Deleted.com was hijacked, it took me an awful lot of time and effort to recover that domain name. And you never know if it's actually gonna be able to recover that domain name or not. And it just seemed like this guy was one step ahead of me all the time. And finally, I was able to convince the registrar to put my contact information in correctly. And I went in, changed the password so that he could not access it again. And then I later sold the website. If you use a free email service like Yahoo or Hotmail for the contact information on your whois, that is a bad idea because they'll end up becoming in non-use if you're not going to use that email address, and then it's up for grabs for anybody to take that domain name away from you. I would rather you take go get a second domain name of whatever, just a cheap name. Like, if you can find your own name.com or whatever, registered for 10 years, and use that as an email address for your big name that you want for your business, and then forward that email address to your regular email or just pop email, however you're going to set it up. But also your big name, your business name, I would suggest you take that name, register it for 10 years too, or somewhere in that 5-10 years, doesn't really matter, but then every year renew it. Don't, even though it may seem like it's ridiculous to renew it because it's already renewed for 5 years, but if you're going to end up having the name drop in 5 years because you forgot to renew it, then you'll be like, well, I wish I would have paid that renewal, because somebody's going to buy up that name in an auction, a drop auction, and may cost you more than, it's going to cost you way more than a renewal fee is going to cost you to recover that name. if anybody has any questions, you can ask me about it. Just, I've kind of it's kind of a hobby for me to learn about domain names and internet security. Not, I don't know everything, but if I can help somebody, then let me know. So, talk to you later. Bye.